Good morning, students. Today we are discussing the chemical properties of an aldehydes and ketones. In the last class, we have discussed the general introduction to the aldehydes and ketones and nomenclature and methods of preparation for the aldehydes and ketones. And also we have seen the physical properties of an aldehyde and ketones. In the today's class, let us discuss the chemical properties of an aldehydes and ketones. The aldehydes and ketones are generally known as carbonyl compounds in which the carbon is bonded with the oxygen with the help of a double bond. In this, the oxygen is more electronegative, therefore the displacement of electron will take place towards the oxygen and the carbon will get a negative charge. Carbon will get a partial positive charge and oxygen will get a partial negative charge. In this, the second one, that is, in this the carbon will consist an sp2 hybridized. The carbonyl carbon is sp2 hybridized and the planar geometry. The geometry is planar. When the displacement of electrons takes place towards the oxygen, then it will get a planar geometry. That is, it will get that. This is an sp2 hybridized and it is a planar structure. That means all the molecules are lies in the same direction. Due to the displacement of an electron towards the oxygen, the carbon will get partial positive charge and oxygen will get a partial negative charge. Due to this partial positive charge, it can easily adapt by the nucleophile. Hence, the aldehydes and ketones will undergo nucleophilic addition reaction. Either due to the displacement of electron, kya hai? Nucleophilic addition reaction carry karte ja. Then let us see what are nucleophilic addition reaction. The mechanism. Let us see the mechanism of an nucleophilic addition reaction. It is telling the nucleophilic mechanism of a nucleophilic addition reaction. In that, consider an example, that is ketone or aldehyde or any carbonyl compound. In this, R and R dash and double bond oxygen. It is a ketone. In that, in this, the carbon and oxygen is a double bond. The displacement of electron will take place towards the oxygen and it will get, the carbon will get partial positive charge and oxygen will get a partial negative charge. This will happen due to the presence, that is, attack of nucleophile. Due to the attack of nucleophile, and this pi electron will be shifted to the oxygen and get partial negative charge, and carbon will get the partial positive charge. In this, the nucleophile will attack from perpendicular direction to the carbon, and the nucleophile will attack from perpendicular direction to the carbon to form an tetrahedral geometry. In this, it is an sp2 hybridized carbon atom and it is shown an planar geometry. Due to the attack of nucleophile, it will get a tetrahedral geometry. It will get the tetrahedral geometry, is R, R dash, and oxygen is negative charge. Due to the attack of a nucleophile, this planar convert converted planar geometry to convert into tetrahedral geometry, and due to the attack of nuclear foil, the sp2 hybridized carbon will get converted into sp3 hybridized carbon, and you will get the tetrahedral geometry. Further, it on acidification, that is addition of hydrogen ion, it will give a product, that is final product R dash and oxygen at the nuclear foil. The place of oxygen, that is hydrogen, will be added. This is the final product in the nucleophilic addition reaction. This is about the general mechanism of a nucleophilic addition reaction. Or if I am going to in this, the carbonyl carbon is sp2 hybridized and planar geometry. Due to the attack of nuclear foil, this electron will be shifted to the oxygen and it will get the partial negative charge, and its planar geometry will be get converted into the tetrahedral geometry, and sp2 hybridized carbon atom will be get converted into the sp3 carbon atom, and the nucleophile attack from perpendicular to the carbon atom, and it will form the addition product, which on acidification it will use the final product. Okay. Let us give an example, that is addition of first one, that is example addition of hydrogen cyanide. Addition of hydrogen cyanide, that is CN. That is that hydrogen cyanide will undergo, that is hydrogen cyanide when it undergo dissociation, it will form the hydrogen ion and cyanide ion. In this, the cyanide ion act as a nucleophile. In this reaction, the cyanide will act as a nucleophile. When we carry the nucleophilic addition reaction, when this react with the aldehydes or ketones, let us consider C R dash R double bond oxygen. Due to the presence of nucleophile, that is due to the presence of nucleophile and CN minus, the displacement of an electron will take place towards the oxygen, and it will get and tetrahedral geometry will be formed. R dash R and single bond, that is oxygen, negative charge and nucleophile. In this, it is an addition product which on further acidification, that is addition of proton, then it will produce the compound, that is final product, that is R dash. And nucleophile here, nucleophile is the cyanide CN and CN here OH. The final product is known as cyanohydrin. The final product is the cyanohydrin. Here, the aldehydes are ketones. When react to the hydrogen cyanide, in that cyanide will act as nucleophile and form the addition product, which on acidification it will give the final product, that is cyanohydrin. Consider it is a ketone, then it is one as ketone cyanohydrin, or aldehyde, then it is aldehyde cyanohydrin. Then consider particular example, that is when aldehyde, that is CH3 C double bond O H, when react with the cyanohydrin hydrogen cyanide, then it will use the compound, it is CH3OH and CNH. This compound is known as cyanohydrin. due to the presence of that is aldehyde, that is acetaldehyde, it is known as acetaldehyde cyanohalide. This much about the addition of hydrogen cyanide reaction. It will carry the nucleophilic addition reaction. Okay, this is the example, and let us see second one example. Second one, that is hydro, first one is the hydrogen cyanide. And let us take another example in that hydrogen cyanide. In that second one, that is we are reacting acetaldehyde with the hydrogen cyanide to form the cyanohydride, acetaldehyde cyanohydride. Let us take an example for ketone. The second example in this, that is this is an A, and let us see the ketones. When the ketones react with hydrogen cyanide, what will happen? When CH3 that is compound is acetone. Generally it is known as acetone. Alkyl is a propanol. When react with hydrogen cyanide, then it will use the cyanohydrin. Here acetone is there, therefore it will use the acetone cyanohydrin, that is CH3 C double bond, that is COH, then CN, then CS. This compound is acetone cyanohydrin. Acetone cyanohydrin. Then second one, that is main second one, first one is the addition of cyanohydrin, so addition of hydrogen cyanide. Second one example, addition of and sodium bisulfite. Addition of sodium bisulfite. The formula for sodium bisulfite is NaHSO3. In the sodium bisulfite, the nucleophile is, let us see what is the nucleophile in the sodium bisulfite. When sodium bisulfite undergo dissociation, it will give the sodium ion and hydrogen sulfide ion. This hydrogen sulfide ion will act as nucleophile in the reaction. Same here, the nucleophile will attack to the aldehydes and ketones and carry out the addition reaction. And finally, on acidification, it will use the and that is bisulfite, aldehyde bisulfite or ketone bisulfite. This we will take in the next class, that is addition of bisulfite, sodium bisulfite. We will see the next class. Okay. Thank you.